You are watching the channel where everything is powered by the sun. So let's calculate some power. Today we're going to be using the shallow well pump to do a freshwater washdown. And yep, that's right, it's solar powered. Let's take a walk over to the solar pavilion. I've got three portable arrays out collecting solar energy from the early morning sun. Today's freshwater washdown will include all of the solar panels, along with the top sides of the solar pavilion and the big red power station. Spoiler alert, it's the all solar powered electric fishing boat. That's in a video up next. Before starting this video series on gathering, storing, and consumption of solar energy, I thought a lot about showing the viewer different tasks or demands that are on a solar-powered storage system. Today's power demo is the shallow well pump. We'll be using the 2000-watt inverter, and we shall be monitoring maximum power draw and continuous sustained power draw. This will be shown on the inverter's LED display, which will in turn allow us to calculate the stored energy used in our battery banks. Wow, that looks so much better. So the shallow well pump performed. The energy that was stored in the batteries worked great. Let's kind of go over some of the voltages and currents needed to run the inverter inside a big red. So the shallow well pump turns on, and when it first turns on at startup, it probably uses about 1600 watts, but it's just for a moment. And then it runs continuously as long as the pump is on, at about 800, 900 watts right in there. I'd say that to make the freshwater wash down, it probably took about 10 to 15 minutes of actual continuous use. So 900 watts, if you divide that by 12, that comes out to about 75 amps of DC current that is needed continuously to run that pump. So we'll break that down even further. 75 amps are needed to run the inverter and the shallow well pump. So let's just say we've got 75 amps times 1/4. That would be about 15 minutes of an hour. That comes out to about 18.6 amps of current that are needed to run that for 15 minutes. All right, so we understand that portion of it. Let's see if we can get to where it's the amount of power that is used. That would be 18.6 times, I'm going to use a reference voltage of 12 volts. So 18.6 times 12 equals about 223 watts. That's a good amount of current, but no problem for the solar pavilion to recharge it. This thing's capable of 800 watts per hour on a good sunny day. And here it is, the Hooty Owl 1060 Surge, all solar powered electric fishing boat. It's pretty sweet. It's got everything. two trailing speeds, 12 volts and 24 volts. It's got electric helm steering, can turn port and starboard. Just flip the switch. And it's got forward and reverse.
The propulsion unit is rather unique. It runs on DC power for trolling, 12 volts and 24 volts, and runs on 110 volt AC power for main propulsion.
Let's open it up, see what's under the hood. That's a 6,500 RPM, 15 amp angle grinder. Come back and watch more of the solar-powered, all-electric fishing boat right here on ATL Solar Trek and Atlantic Drain, where everything is powered by the sun.